introduce you to LISNR. I think there's a few moments in time when you can experience the technology that has the potential to change each and everything you do. I hope that these are one of these moments. There's something that there's a premise to start the technology. There's the whole idea that there are 7 times more speakers in the market today than in the book. And how could you take that speaker network to leverage and touch consumers each and every place to drive unlimited interactions? That's the power of a new standard that's built off of them. So this is a snapshot of, you know, literally 2005 to 2013. But what you're going to notice is a significant change in the fact that we're carrying around these significantly powerful devices. And now it's a part of the experience. I like to say there's 2 seconds screen if you're actually watching the broadcast and you have a phone that's responding to it. You have a phone that's responding to everything. So how could we actually create a technology that could actually touch consumers? Simply everything. This is the group of technology that's currently trying to get today. Whether there's a GPS and you're walking by a location and you get a message, or if you're familiar with IP cams, these are, you know, specific pieces of hardware where you walk around and get a message. And, you know, our audio cousin, which is content recognition, which is very similar to them, and which is recording audio, content ID in it, setting a server, and then making a response. These are all trying to connect with technology. The reality is they're all falling short. They all can't live anywhere. It's significant battery drainage. And most of these are battery and hardware sensitive. I like to say, listen, we can replace them all with our proprietary smartphones. So what we've created are a data over audio solution. Completely silent, thanks to a human ear and a baby. But it has the ability to transmit data over audio through the phone. And we're increasing that data throughput each and every day. Some of the things that you can enable, I'm going to walk through. So most recently, our technology was embedded into this application as an SDK, essentially. And when you went to this Made in America Music Festival, we actually planned our tone across different speakers, creating essentially an audio network. What we were able to do is trigger messaging and content based on where you are without installing additional hardware. So as you approach the concession stand, you receive a $5 coupon. As you walk towards the exit, you receive a ride along with Uber. Right? But while the Live Nation loved it, they didn't have to install additional hardware. And for a consumer, they were able to get content despite not being connected to Wi-Fi or cellular connectivity. And it was all being tracked and triggered based on how tone being broadcasted at that particular venue. We sent over 20 to 30 proximity-based messages per user per day with over 90% rate of engagement. It works, and it works extremely well. Let's go through another example of how we brought this to life. Major League Baseball tried this technology and compared it to iBeacon and really wanted to see how this would work. 3 stadiums, the hours set up in each stadium, and we were able to get 92% coverage by using their current speaker system to drive interactivity within a stadium. This is my favorite example. So an example would be you hit a home run and your phone will respond very similarly. That's an example of when our phone is being broadcast, it's essentially connecting devices and given the content, the ability to synchronize way more accurately than ever before. So, and, you know, you can give me some of this stuff. I'm sorry about that audio, but when our calls are being broadcast, we're giving the consumer or the MLB, for example, the ability to synchronize. So if you're familiar with Shazam or any type of fingerprint wireless solution, you can't synchronize live TV. We can synchronize it to 1/8 of a second of accuracy, which opens up the possibility of these cases and examples of these types of scenarios. So I'm actually going to breeze through a couple of things. Today, we tend to focus in this area, mainly because of the value proposition of driving the type of activity that I discussed. But we're going into a number of places in the future that I want to highlight. maybe on 5 by 10. Either way, most recently, we were on CNBC, disruptive at number 12, above Slack, Spotify, under Cigarette. We were really excited. We were not as funded as some of those companies. But, and most recently, we want to come. Despite the technology sometimes being hard to understand, it really works being able to drive significant amount of engagement and activity across a number of devices, and it's very, very scalable. And the consumers that interact with it love it. And I think it will continue to drive multiple marketing and mobile to mobile interactions for years to come. Thank you.